the Stars, a brand new series, today at 5:45 on the CBBC channel.
Well, hello! The story of Tracy Beaker's on in just a mo. But first, check out the brand new CBBC office! Hello! You were expecting that, were you? We've moved to Salford Quays, and alongside it, we've got loads of new treats in store, like new shows, Deadly Top 10 with Steve Backshaw, and School for Stars. But check out the new desk. We've even got new pens, and I've got a button that makes our notice board do this. Oh, yes, we... Hang on a minute. A laminate flooring catalogue, a picture of meaty produce, and television's very own Sue Barker. You know what this means, don't you? He's here. Oh, yeah, man, hello, I'm here. Enjoying the new office, Hacks?
What?
You enjoying the new office? It's all shiny, isn't it, and fluffy.
Yeah, I just thought you'd buffed it with some sort of citrus-based cleansing cloth.
Whoa, you thought this was the old office?
Yeah.
What was all the... What's that an aid of?
You know what I'm like, Chris. I just thought I'd expel a bit of excess energy.
You've been looking forward to this for months. We're back up north, mate. We're in Salford.
Did you just say Salford?
Yes.
Approximately 17 miles southeast of Wigan, where I'm from. Oh, yes, Wigan, home of Trencherfield Mill and the World Pie Eating Contest.
The very same.
Oh, dear. There you have it. Brand new surroundings. Same old hacker. Here's the story, Tracy Beaker.
Chris?
Yes?
What's a Salford?
And welcome back to my old-style face in the new-style CBBC office. We've got Deadly 60 up next, and guess what? It's all about the new people, because at 5:15 today, we've got new Deadly Top 10 with Steve Backshaw. All about the new...
Ahem!
Yes?
And what do you think you're doing, young yento?
I'm just chilling, relaxing, you know, taking in the nice colour scheme and basking in it.
Oh, it's nice, isn't it? Yeah. But that's not the point. You're not doing anything, are you? The removal van's arrived with all our stuff from the old CBBC office, and I've had to lug it all in on my own.
OK, fine, I'll help you. What, do you need this box
that
now?
That box, yeah. OK, careful.
Oh, hang on. All of Hacker's highly breakable items.
Yes, and I want it placing upon that shelf.
That shelf there?
Yeah.
It's quite high.
I want you to balance it precariously, please.
Precariously?
Would you mind? Go on.
I hope nothing comedic and unfortunate happens, eh? All right, Hacker. Oh, there. Is that all right?
Bit more precarious, please.
Bit more precarious? OK. Yeah. Yeah, slightly off the edge there.
Is bit more, right? Chris. I want it to teeter.
To teeter? To teeter it shall.
Yeah.
There you go. Look at that. It's even wobbling a bit.
Beautiful.
Let's just sit here and hope that nothing unfortunate or comedic occurs. You, seen any good films lately?
No, have you?
No, not really. Well, guess nothing unfortunate or comedic is going to happen after all.
Didn't see that coming.
Me neither. Here's more dangerous animals now in Deadly 60.
Can we keep him?
And one pop star setting an example after storming to the top of the charts again. The British singer and rapper, aka Elliot Glee, has just scored his second number one with Stay Away. OK then, guys, that's it for now. News Round's back this afternoon. See ya.
Autumn's awesome on CBBC.
We have the best adventures.
Look at that!
Wow.
Mission accomplished!
Welcome to the Bat Cave.
Bigger fun, find us somewhere!
CBBC's bringing you tons of new stuff to make your autumn awesome.
CBBC.
Why is he still there?
I don't know. Maybe if we ignore it, it'll go away.
Yeah.
Hi, welcome back to the new CBBC office. We've got Bear Behaving Badly in MO, but first we're keeping everything nice and fresh and innovative, as the Big B Cheese has told us we need to keep it that way.
So let's watch Tracy Barker!
Tracy?
What?
I'm afraid you'll have to move to check out 8.
Oh, but I've got my flask here.
Well, you can take it with you.
All right. Well, pretty much the same, isn't it?
Yeah.
Actually, it's better here because it's nearer the exit. I can get home sooner.
Of course.
Beep. Beep. Beep.
What's that?
I don't know. Just keep waving.
How did the chicken get there too?
Don't question it, Chris. Just wave.
Well, Ian and Hacker will be back this afternoon from 4 with loads of great new shows like Deadly Top 10 and School for Stars. All that singing and dancing. Is Bear Behaving Badly? Last off, and have a look at this. Rafael Nadal was talking to journalists when he collapsed in his chair because of a cramp in his right leg. But don't worry, the Spaniard was soon back on his feet within 15 minutes after receiving some medical attention. That's a lot. I'll see you very soon with another update. Bye-bye.
Autumn's awesome on CBBC.
We have the best adventures.
Look at that!
Wow. Mission accomplished!
Welcome to the Batcave.
Bigger fun, find us somewhere.
CBBC's bringing you tons of new stuff to make your autumn awesome.
Still happen now and then.
Yay! Yeah! Hello! Do you remember me? It's Ian off telly.
Oh, it's you, innit? And it's me, innit?
I'm back from my holidays, yeah. And you might notice something a bit different.
Oh, what's that then?
It's not just that I've had my hair done. We're in a brand new CBBC office.
Oh, Ian, look at it gleam like a majestic waterfowl. See, there's the
proof. Complete with new sound effects here. We have moved to the Salford Quays, and if you look at this window, no expenses spared, you can see in the distance the fantastic city of Manchester, which is real.
Oh. Hold on a minute. That looks like a photograph to me.
Get on board, mate, or get left behind.
Oh, yes! Behold our dazzling structures! I can even detect the sweet yet poignant stench of Wigan in the distance.
I don't think that's Wigan.
Oh, you're right. Yeah. And if you think that's exciting,
if you think windows are exciting, then you probably need to get out more, but watch what happens if I press this button.
Look at that!
Oh, it's meant to say welcome to your new home.
Yeah, I know.
What is it?
It's a duck wearing a hat. It's better and it's funnier. Comedy gold, that.
Well, listen, there is one good thing about this new office.
What is it?
Nelyenko.
Oh, Nelyenko.
Yes, brilliant, yeah.
Hey, Chris. Ian. Sorry.
Surprise. I'll literally not have that.
Good start. What does that button do?
This one here?
Yeah.
Just press it now. Hello?
No.
No!
Oh.
Goodbye!
Ian, can we get the Yonko button deactivated?
Yeah, I'll just get my new mobile phone.
Yeah. Is it on contract?
They're all using these in Salford. Hello? Yeah, we've been yentled. Mm. No, look at it. You watch some Scooby-Doo. Just take him away, put him in the van. See you in a bit.
See ya.
Welcome back to the brand new CBBC office. Still to come, loads of new shows, including Deadly Top 10 and School for Stars.
And I've got a new colour!
Is it new?
No.
CBBC.
Good afternoon, guys. Ricky here with another minute of News Round. First up, the number of stray and abandoned dogs in the UK has reached an 11-year high. The Dogs Trust says around 126,000 strays were picked up by authorities over the past year because their owners couldn't look after them anymore. That's nearly 350 dogs every day. Next, the latest tropical storm in America that's caused flooding is in the southern state of Louisiana. Tropical Storm Lee comes less than a week after Hurricane Irene hit the east coast of the country. And that's not the end of it. A new hurricane, Katia, could also be on its way. Last up, to a man making rather a big splash, comedian David Walliams has set off on his most dangerous sport relief challenge yet. He's swimming the entire length of the River Thames. The 140-mile challenge is expected to take around 8 days. Right, that's your lot. Stay with Ian and Hacker on CBBC. Got to say, I'm loving their view of Manchester. Almost as good as these blobs. Do you think? See you later. Bye-bye.
Live and Deadly is back on the road, and we want you to come with us. The Deadly Days Out are your chance to try out some adventure activities, maybe meet a deadly critter or two. They're happening all over the country, and they're free, but you are going to need a ticket. Head to our website, bbc.co.uk/CBBC. See you there.
And it turns out he was an actual wizard. Oh, sorry, welcome back. We're just having some
wizard best anecdote.
Yeah. As you saw from the man himself, coming up later on today, we have got Steve Backshall in Deadly Top 10. Ooh. And this weekend marks the restart of brand new Live and Deadly. So if you're a Steve Backshall fan, do not miss that. And talking of things new, we are here in the brand new CBBC office.
Oh, Ian, it's so shiny. I find it intimidating.
In a way.
Well, tell you what, mate, what I'll do to make it less intimidating for you.
Yeah.
I'll get some of our old stuff out of this box.
No, 9 million, that's not a box, no.
It's clearly a box, isn't
it? No, it isn't, Ian. That is clearly a portable storage solution. Fashioned from the finest cards, staples and tape in all the land.
Boxes.
It is a box.
Yeah. Okay, let's have a look at all my worldly goods are in here. So we've
what
got
is it?
Pig with Tash.
Wow, we've got a pig with a Tash.
Hi. Oh no, that's everything actually.
That's all you need, isn't it? Ian, will you look in my portable storage solution and see what we've got within?
Yeah. Oh!
What's wrong with it?
Oh!
What's occurred?
It stinks of foul meats, mate.
Foul meats?
Oh, I know what it is.
What?
It's Stephen Greenwood!
Stephen Greenwood. What would the office be like without his wise yet cloudy eyes peering over us?
I tell you what, now the office is back to normal, let's just bask in its homeliness.
Yeah. Oh, Ian, I'm bored. I am bored rigid, I am. Is there some sort of game we can play?
Could play I've Got a Box.
No, we couldn't possibly play that, Ian.
Oh, what could we play?
We could play this new game that I've devised, entitled I've Got a Portable Storage Solution.
What do you think of that, Steve?
Not a fan.
It's not a fan. Okay, so you know the drill by now. If you're a fan of I've Got a Box, we used to play it. I'll leave him in the safety zone over there. If you're a fan of I've Got a Box from back in London days, then email in suggestions for things Hacker can do with his box.
Portable storage solution.
Sorry, portable storage. Maybe it could be a hospital for Stephen Greenwood. Any suggestions?
Maybe it could be a portable storage solution.
CBBC@bbc.co.uk. Email in suggestions and we'll read some out right after Prank Patrol. Email thick and email in fast.
Stephen.
He's gone. Hello!
That fooled him!
We just tricked you using our own minds. Up next, we've got some TSO TBA. Then after that, brand new Steve Baxter's Deadly Top 10. But right now, it's time for the most popular features known to man. It's time for this.
I've got a portable storage solution. Yes, I have.
Yes, a sign for hackers. I've got a box.
No, sorry. A portable storage solution.
Sorry. First one is from Jessica. Hello, Jessica, are you well? She says, use them as pants. They will be way better than your pink dress. Box pants are in this season.
Yes, I've used boxes as pants before.
Oh, is it some here?
That's some there.
Why are they sort of soggy?
Yes, they are. Urine!
Next one is from Oliver. No, Oliver, you can't have any more.
Give him some more.
It's a little joke there. From you watch the film or the play or read a book, whatever. Oliver says, a hairdresser for Ian.
You've got a portable storage solution.
I've got a box. Nah. Sorry, portable storage solution. Yeah. Does just that look? I'll just put on the portable storage solution now. Just get my hands in for extra purchase. There we go.
I imagine what's.
Been to the hairdresser, mate.
What's going on?
Finally, we've got one here from Caitlin. Oh, Caitlin, are you well? Caitlin says, hacker,
yes.
Can you make a disco box? By the way, hacker, I love you and can we go on a date?
I love you too, but no, and I will make it into a box. A disco thing.
Okay, people, we need more suggestions for your portable storage solution. CBBC, BBC, Recorder, UK. Email them in thick and email them in fast. We'll see you right after Trace Baker, TSO TV.
Sure to escape swarms of killer bees, rampaging hippos and hungry crocodiles in Deadly Dash. Run and jump over obstacles whilst taking pictures of beautiful and endangered species. Dash on over to bbc.co.uk/CBBC and click on games.
Autumn's awesome on CBBC.
We have the best adventures.
Look at that!
Wow.
Mission accomplished!
Wow!
Brilliant.
Welcome to the Batcave.
Bigger fun, find us somewhere!
CBBC's bringing you tons of new stuff to make your autumn awesome.
Hello, welcome. If you've just joined us from BBC One, then you are just in time for some Steve Baxter's Deadly Top 10. And if you're a Steve Baxter fan, this Saturday on the CBBC channel, you can catch the man himself in Live and Deadly.
He's good, isn't he?
He's very good. So let's do something that doesn't involve him in any way whatsoever. Yeah. It's time for this.
I've got a portable storage solution.
What's that noise?
It's just that thing I do.
You do that. Lucy, hello. Emails and first with suggestions for Hacker's Box.
Let's pop a storage saloon.
Sorry. I am so glad you guys are back on our screens in that swanky new office. You are welcome.
Thank you.
Anyway, I think that the inside of the box will be a massive 3D cinema with all your favourite CBBC programmes.
Here, let's have a look.
Get inside, look. I've got some Steve Batchel on there for you.
Oh, look! Steve's in 3D!
Just be careful of the 3D elephants.
Oh, they're coming here! Oh! Ooh, we were upset.
You got tusked then.
Yeah.
We've got one here from Caitlin. Hello, Caitlin. It could use it as a moustache for Pig with Tash. It could even make him have a beard.
I'll try it on him.
Like, I don't think Pig with Beard would work, though, would
no,
it?
No, let's try the sting.
Go.
Pig with Beard.
No, doesn't feel right, does it? No. Email in cbbc@bbc.co.uk. We need more suggestions for things Hacker can do with his box.
Email. What about storage solutions?
Sorry. Email in thick and fast. We'll see you right after Steve Baxter and brand new Deadly Top 10 over and out Run Network. Mom, you told me everyone in Salford was using these phones. So right now it's time for this.
I've got a portable storage solution.
Hello, yes, you've been emailing in suggestions what I can do. What are you doing? With his box. This is before we talk about School for Stars, brand new all singing, all dancing show coming up next. And today, the kids go back to school, so it might ring a few bells with you guys.
Sounds exciting, hey. I like bells.
Hey, ring a bell. So let's read some emails. First one's from Lily. Hi, Lily, are you well? Get off of me. Could you use it as a mask for Ian, she says.
Ian, do you remember the last time that I got you confused with the box?
Yeah, I don't want to remember that moment ever again.
Let's remember it now!
Oh, no!
It's so much nicer working with you at the moment. You're somehow different these days. And you smell better for a kick-off. Ha. Now go on, tell all the nice people what's coming up next. Come on, Ian, tell them what's on. Ian! Look, it's easy, just do it! Do your job! Right, that's it. Oh, Ian, what have I done? Right, you all saw it, didn't you? He fell! Yes, he fell! And they did.
You all right, mate? How's it going?
Ian?
Yeah?
But if you're there, then who did I just maim? I must go on the run!
You're the slowest runner I've ever met.
I know, I really, really am.
Do a run now. Look how slow it is. He walks quicker. You literally walk quicker.
What?
Doesn't matter, forget it. Email in, cbbc@bbc.co.uk. What can Hacker do with his box? Sorry. Portable storage device.
What solution? Come on.
Solution, sorry. Up next, we have got School for Stars. See you right after that.
I'm going to go for a run.
Run network. Wow. School for Stars there. I can tell you for what, I was on the edge of my seat.
So was I.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
What was your favourite bit of it?
Oh, the mild peril.
That was good. Anyway, it's now time. We just can't go for School for Stars. It's now time for this.
I've got a portable storage solution. Wonder who'll get the part.
No way! Oh!
What's
we were
on?
So caught up in the euphoria of School for Stars.
Yeah.
We've only gone and forgot about your portable storage device. Look at all these emails. We've got no time to read them out now.
Oh, Ian, if only there was a way we could sort of plough through them fastly. Fast blow!
First one's from Esther. Esther says you can make the portable storage solution into a fancy dress shop, and Ian, you can see you do the monkey dance.
I can't do the fancy dress bit.
I can do the monkey dance.
Yay! What a simian.
Woo!
Fast plow!
Little Miata says, I think the box should be a storage place for all Hacker's different sandwiches.
It was, but I ate them all.
What was your favourite flavour?
The sandwich flavour.
Sure, bread. Next one is from Charlotte. Make it a robot butler.
I can't, but I could be a robot butler. Tea or coffee? Tea or coffee?
Sounds like a Dalek.
Tea or coffee?
Fionn says, Betson's dog Betty loves you.
Hello!
Can you make the box a table for two in a fancy restaurant?
Yeah.
Dog.
Yes, Ian.
There's something I've always wanted to tell you.
Tell me aloud.
I love the monkey dance! That's all for today! We'll be back tomorrow morning, 7:30 a.m. I'm not there, Chris is, but hey, you can't have everything. Right now, it's time for Deadly 60, because to be honest, Steve Baxter's not been on enough today. Have you had fun today?
No!
All sorts of fun. Thank you for joining us. This is the new CBBC office here in Salford. We'll be back tomorrow at 4 p.m. Bye! Have a banana, people!
Ta-ta.
Have a banana!